a dream there waiting for a dreamer to dream her. Barely just a spark in the open darkness of the ether, the world beneath. Saw it coming, then one day, all of a sudden, there was you, 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 you.
Don't be afraid, I are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. The other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamt I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken, so I hung my head and cried. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
This wasn't the 50. Wait, I'm 48.
Uh-oh. This is awkward. Oh, wait, there's more!
What's this?
Huh?
Someone get the paddles out.
That's what he was saying.
You guys say that every time.
Come here.
You just stop. How are you?
Put your hand in mine. what a journey when I hear people on the TV saying, kids, not me. They cost too much, they're trouble, they break your heart. I say, you're missing out on the best things in the world. You're ninny. Ninny come poop. Nincompoop. You just said that wrong.
Okay, last night, Mom got some extra strong pain meds because of her feet. And so she had some crazy dreams. Mom, tell us about those dreams you had last night.
We put people in a triangle.
What kind of people? Bad people?
There was bad people, good people. There was one was Kai.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
And one was Chris.
You shot Chris?
Yeah.
Did you shoot Kai?
Yeah.
Who's the bad people that you shot? You said you shot some bad people.
One guy I didn't recognize.
But he was a bad guy, huh?
He was a bad guy. And you and I shot him.
Holy
and then we had to put him in a well.
Put him in a well?
Yeah.
Oh, we're going to make people sick who drink the well water.
We push the well over to the bad guy. And then...
What do you mean push the well? How do you push a well?
I don't know. I said, Trevor, I don't get it. Where does the water go?
What?
And you said, don't worry about it. It'll move with us.
Okay.
And then we pushed it over to another bad guy.
Did we kill that bad guy?
Yeah.
How are we killing these bad guys?
Shooting them.
Shooting them? So we got some guns, huh? Just going around killing people.
You said they'll never recognize the bullet. Because it's a different type that I got in Europe. And
that's some crazy dreams. So, did you have any other dreams last night? I want to hear if you had any other crazy dreams like that.
Oh, you turned our whole house into those houses where they go with ghosts and goblins.
Like for Halloween?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So like a haunted house for Halloween. Okay.
A haunted house.
Were you part of the show?
Scared me to pieces. And I said, I'll never trust you again. And you said, well, wasn't it fun to go in the ghost house? And I said, no. You scared me. And the haunted house, it was this house.
It was this house, huh?
Yeah.
Okay. Any other dreams we need to talk about and record?
Put webbing all over so I'd feel like...
Spider webs?
Spider webs. And you had people in hiding in the ducts. The heating ducts. Kai was hiding and moving the heating duct. That one was replaced and she slid it back and forth to make me think there was a ghost.
Maybe there was a ghost in there.
No, it was Kai. Because she waved two fingers at me.
So they were Kai's fingers for sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I'm telling you, I said, why did you do it? And you pretended to not know what I was talking about. Some guy walked in and he said, you read his due. And we're not renting this house
right
to you ever again. You go in there and clean it up.
Really? So I pissed off the landlord and I'm not the landlord, huh, in the dream?
You're not the landlord.
Okay.
And you made the ceiling piled with rags.
Rags on the ceiling?
Yeah.
And then
I said, how does that work? And you said, I don't know what you're talking about.
Sounds like there's a whole lot of denial going on in this dream, huh?
Oh, honey, you had this house so rigged.
You're going to try to hold it.
Just a minute.
You're going to break out the other hand?
Yeah.
This hand's useless. That hand's worse than this hand. And you're going to break that hand out, huh? To help. Yeah. She hasn't brought that thing out for a while. It's been rusting in the shed. All right.
You want to see me?
Nope, I don't, because it's a mess that I'll have to clean up.
That's all I dared.
Love you, Mom.
Love you, Candace. This has been a good day.
Yeah.
A really good day. She is one heck of a mom. She is wonderful.
Yes.
So much love. Was normally a very happy up person. To be around her was joy. This was the first time Mom could get away from school teaching because she was taking classes at the U and blew a tire and the car rolled over him and Tammy was thrown to the side of Mom, so Mom took the heavy brunt of the wreck. I assume that she didn't feel a lot of pain because her neck, from the neck down, she was paralyzed.
Your mom was?
That wouldn't have been a good life for my mom.
Mm-mm. I didn't know that.
In a wheelchair.
I didn't know she was paralyzed.
Yeah.
Mm.
And so then Dad went back to his room and he wrote me a letter explaining what had happened and feeling good because Mom had seemed to him really good, and the doctors weren't straight with him, didn't tell him that she was hurt as bad as she was. Maybe it's out of kindness, you know, not wanting to scare him or whatever.
Yeah,
I'm not judging. And when he was finished writing the letter, a nurse came running in his room and said, if you want to see your wife, better run down the hall. And he said, what are you talking about? I just talked to her and she was fine. And he went back and she was gone. Mm. There's a hymn that I love. It's Lead Kindly Light, One Step Enough for Me. And the people went, they don't think when they say, oh, I'd love to see the future. No, you wouldn't step up. You'd lay in bed.
You'd go and crawl into a ball of fear.
You coward. If I had known what I was... I've got to have some.
Yep.
So, Connor and...
Yeah, the car, Maddie. Yeah.
And I said, above all, be kind. If you have a choice of being right, it doesn't hurt you if somebody's right and you're mixed up, or maybe just let it go. Be kind. If there's a choice, always let it be kind. Always.
Mm. Yeah.
I remember one time somebody said to me, well, Mom, you're not right all the time. Like
was that
you
me?
Think you are. Does it sound like you?
Yeah, kind of. Kind of sounds like me.
Yeah. You're 19. I'm telling you, 17 to 19 is really hard on parents.
Oh, shoot. Ash is 16.
Yeah, I know. I'm loving the pieces.
Oh, it's me.
It's my adorable Candace Pooh. Used to think you could get away with being with your brothers, but that wasn't gonna happen. They were on to you. You thought being cute was enough.
It's got me this far in life.
Well, you got by with them for a while. But then they stopped you.
What'd they stop me from doing?
Oh, mischief. You're good at that. Nothing bad. Just spilled stuff on the floor or the counters. And then blamed it on them.
I did not.
Yes, you did. I saw you one time and I couldn't believe it. And I thought, she'll just do okay. She won't. Let them stop her. My right leg is jumping.
Is it?
What a goofball legs. These legs were not made for dance. Or apparently walking either. Oh well. If crawling is what I have to do, I'll do it.
You gonna crawl?
Hey, you do what you can, right?
Yeah. You remember when you fell a few years ago and the only way you could get around was doing the Charleston?
Mm-hmm.
Do you remember when you had to do the Charleston to move around?
Yeah.
I have it on video. Do you want to see it?
Yeah.
Digital age, you don't have to do it on your phone.
No, I don't have to lift them. If I don't have to lift them and I can get around. He said, you literally do the Charleston? And I said, yeah, I can balance and do the Charleston. And that's how I get around in the bathroom is doing that. Oh, well, it works. And just send that to Derek. He said, Mom, you got to send that.
Looking out.
So we have the issue here with the claw that continues to pull the blanket and pull the blanket and pull the blanket. So what I do now is I tuck the blanket in outside the claw, and then we bring a little baby blanket just for the claw. Now if the claw untucks itself, the rest of the body stays warm. Say hi to Chris and Wendy. I'm going to send this to Chris and Wendy. Willis, say hi to Chris and Wendy. Can you give him a one finger up? Love you, Willis. I know, but do we have some blue pants to match so you're not in these green trousers? Or should we just wait till I spill something on this shirt and then switch it out for a green shirt?
Into the night sky. This too shall pass. Kind of like kidney stones.
Million stars shine.
What are you thinking, Willis?
This is taking a longer time than I thought. Guess they don't want me there because I'll mess things up.
You think so, huh?
Yeah. Mom wants me, but the rest aren't sure if I'll calm down or drive them crazy.
We'll see it and throw. But tired, shift a whisper of wave with silver hair from your eyes. I'd never seen you unkempt before. As you whispered, darling, close the door. Well, how?
stars down from the sky. I'll not forget the chaos in your eyes, love. And as you not.
Say, love is what you put into it. You say that I'm losing my will. Don't you know that you're all that I think about? You make up a half of the whole. You say that it's hard to commit to it. You say that it's hard standing still. Don't you know that I spend all my nights counting backwards the days till I'm home? When you're scared and alone, just know that I'm already home. I say that we're right in the heart of it, a love only we understand. I will bend every light in this city and make sure they're shining on you. When you're scared and alone, just know that I'm already home. When life takes its own course, sometimes we just don't get to choose. I'd rather